Publicist, Sean Gibbons, man. How you feeling today?
Feeling great, man. Feeling like anticipation. We're getting close. We're less than about 8 days away. I'm feeling good.
Knucklehead Boxing got a big 2 weeks. I mean, you got Casimora fighting this week against Rigondeaux. Talk to us a little bit about that.
Casimero's exciting, man. There's no Filipino like him. The guy is has swag, backs it up, and he's looking to make a tremendous appearance on August 14th at a little coming out party. Even though he's won 5 world titles in 9 different countries, people in America really don't know him. So it's a big moment for him. I'm really excited.
And August 21st, you fight another Cuban.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Filipinos versus Cuban taking over the last month's, last week's August.
Now, really, really weird world how that's come about. You know, and there's never been really Filipinos versus Cubans at all at any level. So to have two at the highest level, I'm not sure we're going to start creating a rivalry or we're just going to, you know, we're definitely going to start a rivalry of Philippines beating Cubans.
And I got to ask you, the big news yesterday, Earl had to pull out. What was your reaction? I know the whole team was looking forward to going into a clash with Earl. What was your reaction?
Well, my reaction, first and foremost, was Earl's health. Make sure Earl's okay. I'm so happy. It's bittersweet. I'm happy he discovered it, and we were bummed at the same time, but would never want him to go into the ring that he's not 100%. So very happy that they did find the injury. Wish the best for Earl. He was in surgery today. I saw a picture. He already came out. So hopefully, possibly, we can revisit this fight towards the end of the year. But of course, it's disappointing for everybody. But you really got to look at it. So Ugas, this ain't a guy taking a fight at the last minute replacement. This is a man that stole the belt from Manny Pacquiao. So it's kind of poetic justice that Manny is coming back to get his belt. And in the meantime, he'll break his record and become the oldest welterweight champion at 42 years and 8 months. So, don't let anybody, it's a little letdown, but at the end of the day, man, this is still a real fight. This is Manny Pacquiao, and this could be his last fight in the U.S., maybe not, maybe come back or something. So it's definitely something people want to tune into, and if they get a chance to go live, and you haven't seen Manny Pacquiao, him and Ugas are going to be fireworks.
And I know it was just announced yesterday that it was a changing opponent. Do you think Manny's more motivated to try to get the redemption since the belt was his, and they didn't give it back to him, and now he's got to fight the guy? Like he's defending his own title.
Yeah, no, it definitely, big time. When he looks across and old boy's strapping that thing on and walking around like I'm the champ, Senator is not a boisterous, not a boastful, not a guy, but I am. And that's absolutely, Senator will have a little smirk on his face going, okay, yeah, you want to call yourself that? Well, at the end of the day, we're going to see who the real super champion is.
Woo! Where can the fans keep up with you on Instagram?
They can find me at Knucklehead Sean. They can find me down at the park late nights drinking wine. but anywhere else, just always find me Knucklehead Sean.
Thank you so much.
Tell me you want that.